afternoon and welcome to St. Ignatius. Before we begin the Mass, may we ask those who are seated please move to the center of the pews so that those who come late may find it easier to be seated. And may we ask all of you with cell phones, pagers, smartphones, and all of that to turn them off during the duration of the Mass. And we kindly ask you please take no photos, no pictures during the Mass. Take them before the Mass or after the Mass. We also remind you that the rows in the back on the right side are reserved for those with small children. There is a crying room behind it. Please feel free to use it at any time. We also ask you to please not leave any litter behind. And also, if you feel it necessary to feed your child or to eat or drink during the Mass, please do so outside. Thank you. Today we celebrate the third Sunday of Advent. The celebrant this afternoon is Father Arun D'Souza. Assisting at the altar are Kiyomashina, Rina, Shania, Jotham, Arsi, Niai, Kenji, and Katrina. The Eucharistic ministers are Takano-san, Takasaki-san, Kato-san, and Nakayama-san. The first reader is Indy, the second reader is Gyoko. I will be your lector, my name is Douglas, and we will be using the short creed, the Apostles' Creed, during the Mass today, which is on page 14 of the hymnal. Please all stand and join the choir in singing entrance number 300. Entrance in number 300, verses 1, 4, and 5.
First reading. A reading from the prophet Zephaniah. Shout for joy, daughter of Zion. Israel, shout aloud. Rejoice, exult with all your heart, daughter of Jerusalem. The Lord has fulfilled your sentence. He has driven your enemies away. The Lord, the King of Israel, is in your midst. You have no more evil to fear. When that day comes, word will come to Jerusalem. Zion, have no fear. Do not let your hands fall limp. The Lord your God is in your midst, a victorious warrior. He will exult with joy over you. He will renew you by his love. He will dance in shouts of joy for you, as on the day of festival. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial psalm. Let our response be: cry out with joy and gladness, for among you is the great and holy one of Israel. Please repeat.
No intimidation, no go to Vietnam to fight the war. Very sad news. But son goes to the war and keeps writing to his father practically every day, explaining to him what's happening. And one day, his letters stop. Following day, father receives a letter. Your son has been killed while attempting to rescue another soldier. Father feels sad. 6 months later, there was a knock on his door. And a young soldier with a large package under his arm comes in and says, "Sir, you don't know me, but I am the man your son saved on that fateful day. He died in the deep jungles of Vietnam. Your son was my friend, and we spent many a lonely night in the country talking about you and your love for art." And he hands over the package to the father. "I know this isn't much. I'm not much of an artist. But I wanted you to have this painting I've done of your son as I last remember him." Father opens the painting and tells the soldier, "You have captured the essence of my son's smile with his painting. And I wish I will cherish this above it above all others." And the painting is hanged at the entrance of the house. After a couple of years, father dies. There is no one after him. So according to his will, whole collection of his father and the son, all the paintings are put on auction. Everybody is gathered. The auction is about to start. And the manager of the auction company brings out the painting of the son and says, "Who will start the bidding? $200? No one. $300? No one. They come down. $100? No one. There was no one to bid for the painting of the son. Ultimately, a young soldier comes in and says, "All I have is $10. And I want this painting." Everybody is stunned. Everybody is waiting for the Picasso, the fire, or other important paintings. And this young man, with $10, bidding for this, an unimportant painting. Everybody is angry. Everybody is telling to him, "We need the next ones." Ultimately, the young soldier buys the painting for $10. And the manager says, "The auction is closed." Okay, everybody is agitated. Everybody is angry. How come the auction is closed? Only one painting has been sold, and there are many others. The president of the auctioning company comes forward and says, "According to the wishes of the deceased, only the painting of the son was to be sold today. And whoever takes the son gets it all. So today, for $10, this young man has bought one of the world's most precious art collections and the entire estate in which it is housed." Auction closed. And with that saying, he hands over the painting to the young soldier. Probably, everybody was angry. Everybody is agitated. Everybody wants to have bigger paintings. But here, the man, the soldier, goes home with the son, the painting of the son, and also with the whole rare collection. You can't stop trying to be good for God. If you take the son, you will get everything. years of the Vatican Council too. A special grace, a special year for believers. You know, they say when a lion walks in the forest, it is very royal. After walking a certain distance, the lion stops, looks behind its journey that it has journeyed, and then again keeps moving forward. I think this Advent season is something like that for us. We stop, look what is behind us, and then we go forward. Year of faith is also going to be such a time for us. Time to stop, to look behind, and proceed. In today's gospel, we see John the Baptist giving practical advices to his people, to the people, to the tax collectors, to soldiers. In a sense, we are also included in his invitation. No vague answers, not impractical, not impossible. Very clear and practical things. John says, give your poor to the poor. Give food. Do not take what is beyond expected. Be kind to the people. Do not demand more than expected. Do not terrorize people in the name of protecting them. I think they are applicable even today. Am I going to listen to God today? Am I going to be generous with my preparation to receive Jesus? St. Basil the Great says, the bread in your cupboard belongs to the hungry. The coat unused in your closet belongs to the one who needs it. The shoes rotting in your closet belong to the one who has no shoes. The money which you hold up belongs to the poor. What is going to be my preparation to receive Jesus? Do we have Son? Do we have Jesus? The question of today invites us on this third Sunday of the Advent. What would I correct in my life in order to receive Jesus, in order to celebrate Christmas in a worthy, pure heart? Question keeps ringing. Do I have a Son? Do I have Jesus in my life? And if I have Jesus in my life, I have everything. For $10, the young soldier receives the whole collection of paintings. In the same way, if only we have Jesus, if we only have Son, probably our faith keeps telling us we have everything in life and we do not need anything else. Shall we prepare ourselves to receive this Christ, this Son, this Jesus in our lives?
Please stand.
Thank you.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
you are all our joy. For today's cold world of management and production, with its manipulation and injustice, that it may again pay attention to people and regain a sense of joy and celebration, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
you are all our joy. For the poor and those who suffer, that we may give them not only what they need, but bring them the warmth of our love and the joy of hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
you are all our joy. For Christians everywhere, that we may learn to keep our serenity in trials that are part of the life, part of this life, and that we may see the relative value of things, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for all of us, that we may have a sense of humor that can laugh at our own expense, and a sense of gratuitousness, that can do things for free, out of pure joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
you are all our joy.
Thank you.
mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
In memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, this life-giving bread, this giving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share in the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love, together with Benedicta, Pope, Peter, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember all our friends whom you have called from this life. In baptism, they died with Christ. May they also share his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in the hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen. Please stand. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel. Please be seated. And may we ask you to please return the kneelers to the place and space in front of you to help with the passage for communion. year, please remember the children who have not yet received their first Holy Communion, as well as adults who have not been baptized and may not partake of the host. However, please come forward with your heads bowed and receive a blessing. Please join the choir in singing the communion hymn number 683. Hymn number 683, verses 1 and 3.
Thank you.
have many special announcements today, so please listen carefully. There will be confessions in Tagalog that will be heard after this Mass until 3:30. So again, confessions in Tagalog will be heard after this Mass until 3:30. And I'll give you Hindi to say it in Tagalog.
Sa mga gustong magkumpisan, meron po tayo, umiyalan po tayo sa may bandang liwaran po natin sa may bandang sa bago po maglabasa. Doon po tayo magkumpisan. Ito po ay sa Tagalog, pwede rin po ito sa Ingles. At matatapos po ito ang mga nasa destination.
If you have set up a nativity crib in your home, please let us have the photos for it before December the 20th. So we will be having again this year the nativity crib contest. So for details, please see the December bulletin or inquire at the church office. Since many people go to confession during Advent, you are urged to go early as there will be many coming on December the 23rd and 24th, and shortly before Christmas. So please try to get to confession as quickly as possible if you have not already done so. The schedule of Christmas Masses and confessions is published in the bulletin as well as in the handouts, which are in the vestibule, the entrance of the church. So please look at that. If you have any confessions, inquire at the English Center. We are seeking new members to serve on the church council during 2013, next year, as well as 2014. So again, we are seeking new members to serve on the church council during 2013 and 2014. If you would like to recommend someone, please use the forms provided at the church entrance or inquire at the English Center. On Saturday, December the 22nd, at 2 in the afternoon in the main chapel here, there will be a Christmas Mass for children and their parents or guardians. We are all invited to attend. That's Saturday, December 22nd, 2 p.m., a Christmas Mass for children. Every year, a group from our church sings Christmas carols in the neighborhood around the church. You are all welcome to join them on Saturday, December the 22nd, at 3:30. For details, please see the handouts that will be available at the entrance of the church. There will be a meeting of the English-speaking international community today at 1:30 in room 404. That's, again, an English-speaking international community meeting at 1:30 in room in room 404. So please come, bring a friend. There's choir practice today, also for the English Christmas Eve Mass from 1:30 in room 201. So the choir practice for the English Christmas Eve Mass from 1:30 today in room 201. And the Kalakai calendars, planners, a date book for 2013, which is a very practical gift for Christmas, is on sale today outside the church. Please pick up a calendar or two. And for regular requests, thank you for not eating, drinking, or feeding your children inside the church. Please take home the missalettes with you, as the readings for the week are written on the back. Also, please return the needles to the proper places in front of you, as well as the hymnal books in the pews. Please join us after Mass today in praying the Holy Rosary outside in front of Our Lady statue, which is to the right as you exit. Thank you for your cooperation. Please stand.
And in you.
293, hymn number 293, verses 1 and 7.